Afghanistan, a country plagued with violence and poverty for the past 50 years, is perhaps the last place in the world where one would expect successful mega projects. However, despite endless hardships and misery, Afghanistan has launched and is now halfway through the implementation of its first mega project, the Qosh Tepa Canal. Once completed, the canal will be one of the largest and longest artificial rivers in the world, providing irrigation for the region. The Qosh Tepa Canal is a 285-kilometer-long, 152-meter-wide, and 8-meter-deep artificial river in northern Afghanistan that extends from the Amo Darya River, starting in the Balkh province and ending in Faryab while passing through Yauzian. Approximately more than half of the canal has been completed, and the rest is being built at a rather fast pace due to an ongoing growing water and food shortage crisis across the country. Several countries that share the Amu Darya River with Afghanistan have expressed their concerns about the canal's impact on their share of the river water. However, Afghanistan has reassured them that such a scenario will not occur. It has also clarified that it is the only country that does not benefit from the river, and therefore is entitled to its share. The canal is an urgent matter for the people of North Afghanistan, which has transformed into an arid desert over the past few decades due to global warming, declining groundwater reservoirs, and inadequate irrigation systems. The canal is expected to provide water to over 1 million Afghans and enable thousands of farmers to return to agriculture. The project aims to convert 55,000 hectares of land into farms, with a strong emphasis on grains and wheat. In fact, the country's goal is to become a wheat exporter by 2028. The project commenced in March 2022 and will be completed in three phases. The first two phases involve the actual digging of the canal, while the third phase is dedicated to the installation of water irrigation systems and other infrastructure. The Afghanistan National Development Corporation is managing the project, which is fully funded by the government through tax revenues. The initial cost estimate was set at $500 million, while new projections indicate that an additional $100 million will be required. It's remarkable how the Afghans managed to undertake such a massive project with limited and outdated equipment, a small number of experienced engineers, and no external assistance. The government funded and designed the project based on extensive land surveying and soil studies. One of the primary goals of these studies was to ensure that water lifts were not required, reducing associated costs and preventing flooding during winter. They also ensured that the canal path was located on the most fertile lands and near towns and villages along the way. Once the canal path was established, 200 private contractors were deployed across 114 sections, representing the first phase, which spans 108 kilometers. As many as 7,000 haul truck and excavator drivers, among others, including project engineers, worked and are still working on the project as they have moved to phase two, which is 177 kilometers long. Contractors would arrange dozens of excavators in a line with sufficient space in between for haul trucks. The trucks would then be loaded and depart in an orderly manner to unload their loads in designated low elevation areas nearby. Once a section is dug and approved by engineers and supervisors, the machines move to the next section and replicate the process according to detailed maps and specifications. The entire project involved building 14 hydraulic gates topped by a bridge for vehicles. These gates were constructed to prevent floods during the winter and rainy periods when the Amu Darya River levels rise. During the final stage of building phase one, up to 1 million cubic m of soil were removed daily, which is quite impressive. Most of the excavators and haul trucks used were old and in some cases from the 1960s. Additionally, the canal banks have been reinforced with thousands of trees to prevent soil erosion. Also, a 20-kilometer area has been planted with various crops to test the soil and irrigation system's effectiveness. Moreover, the project has created an economic boom in the nearby areas where people are benefiting from employment opportunities. The contractors have been paying their workers well and on time despite some hateful reports. Another exciting observation is the diversity in the workforce and the high level of optimism among farmers, workers, and residents despite years of negative environmental factors like droughts and wars. The entire project was initially planned to be completed by 2028, but the current progress suggests that it might be ready as early as 2025. More bridges and culverts are also under construction, which is a great sign of progress. It's essential to emphasize that Afghanistan's good portion, mostly rural and remote areas, are facing famine due to the country's harsh sanctions. We do hope that more mega projects related to water management, farming, electricity, and infrastructure will follow this amazing project, which is bound to help Afghanistan heal from the wounds of wars and become a productive member of the international community. What do you think? Can Afghanistan, under the Taliban's rule, complete this mega project and initiate new ones? Let us know in the comments section. We hope you enjoyed this episode of 4 Minutes Marvels. As always, thank you for watching. We'll see you in the next video.